Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Mysteries Will Be Solved. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 9-10. It says, "For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when completeness comes, what is in part disappears." Children, there are so many things in this world that we do not understand, but the bright and beautiful day is coming when we shall know fully, even as I am fully known. Every boy and girl, in fact, all of us, are intrigued and fascinated by mysterious things. In this world, sometimes mysteries cannot be solved. But we know that however uncanny a situation or a thing may seem to be, our God knows the answer. A little girl I know was afraid of the dark. Each night, when her mother put her to bed, she would cry when the lights were turned off. One night, by the time the mother had reached the bottom of the stairs, she realized that the light was on again. She went upstairs at once and scolded her daughter for turning it on. But the little girl said, "Mother, I didn't turn on the light." The mother comforted the child and prayed with her, and turned the light off again, and went downstairs. Again, the light came on. This time, when she went upstairs, the mother thought she would have to spank her daughter for disobedience. But first, she began to study the situation. To her surprise, she discovered that the light switch was too high on the wall for the little girl to have reached it, and there was no chair in the room for the girl to climb on. Again, the daughter with tears protested that she hadn't turned on the light. This time, the mother believed her. But how did the light come on? There was something uncanny about the experience, particularly since they lived in a mission field where the belief in devils and spirits was strong. This was a small mystery, but the mother could not solve it. Together, the mother and daughter knelt by the bed and prayed earnestly, claiming the promise of God's protection. The mother slept that night, and there was no more problem with the lights. Knowing only a little about something mysterious can be annoying. We look forward to heaven even when all mysteries will be solved, and the imperfect will be done away. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, have you ever experienced a mysterious situation or condition? Have you ever had a strange experience like that little friend? Children, there are many things that are a mystery to us in this world. There are many imperfections that appear before us. And of course, this might make us feel afraid and also have negative prejudice about the situation. But God's word this morning teaches us that all mysterious things, all imperfect things will be changed when Jesus comes the second time. Therefore, today, while waiting for the second coming of Jesus to pick us up, pray to God to help you have faith in Jesus and remain faithful and believe in Him. Believe that all mysteries will be revealed when Jesus comes, and He will change everything that is imperfect to be perfect. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.